Today, we will going to see how a file will be distributed into the cluster in the real world. How Hadoop file will going to be distributed into the cluster in the real world. And this is Srinivas and explaining about this Hadoop distributed file system. So, let's talk about that particular part. So, as I spoke, Hadoop file system means it will divide and distribute, whereas your network file system won't do it out. Okay. So, we already seen, if you have not seen, please refer the video, what are the advantages of dividing the data. And now we will going to see how data will be distributed. So, before talking about distributed, let me talk about the different machines that people will use in the real world. So, first of all, when I say Hadoop file system means a Hadoop should be installed on the cluster. So, first the terminology that I am going to use is what called cluster. Do you know what is meant by cluster, right? Cluster is nothing but a collections of different nodes. I can give you a simple definition as well. So, you know what is meant by a node, right? A node is nothing but a simply one commodity machine. A collections of nodes is called racks, and a collections of racks is called data centers. A collections of data centers is called cluster. So, your administrator team will going to build a distributed systems, I mean to say like a cluster. So, a cluster usually contains a master. Hadoop cluster usually contains master and slaves. That is master, and these are called slave 1 and slave 2 and slave 3 and slave 4. So, this cluster will be up and running by the administration team. So, the role of administrator is maintain the cluster and manages the cluster. Here, as these are a commodity machines, at any time any slave in that cluster may lost. So, your administrator should take the responsibility of manages the cluster. If any slave lost, it will going to send an alert to our administrator, and administrator will going to respond to that one promptly and make that machine available for the data processing things. So, the first terminology I want to introduce is what called cluster. So, this cluster usually follows a master slave model. Remember this cluster, right? You no user or no developer will not connect to the cluster, and they will not going to do anything in the cluster side. Remember, you don't have any access to log into the cluster. So, then what is the tool you will going to use? So, there will be something called, another terminology I want to introduce, that is called gateway machine, or you can call it as edge node, or you will call it as a client machine. Okay, so this is what a gateway machine. Here, this machine is configured in such a way to connect to the master. So, in this machine, people install Hadoop client, and they will going to change all configuration details and everything in this gateway machine. So, there will be a multiple gateways to the cluster. Okay, but you know, usually you will going to have access through one gateway only to the cluster. This gateway is configured in such a way to connect to the cluster. You can check out one site.xml called core site.xml. You can refer there. It will mention that to which master you have to configure. This is the main machine that developer will going to use. So, the first task is what cluster, administrator will log into the cluster and he will start the cluster. Once he starts the cluster, master will be up and the slaves will going to start sending heartbeat to that particular masters. The role of the slave is what? Sending heartbeat to the master. Okay. This is what the responsibility is. Okay, fine. So, step 1, you start the cluster. and the slave will going to start sending heartbeat to the master. Why? Because this in the slave master architecture, the minimum responsibility that slave has to do it is what? Send a heartbeat to let master know that they are available for taking tasks. Okay. Now, and developers will use a gateway machine to place a file. And the third one, which is not least, that is your local machine. You know, whenever you go into appoint as a data engineer in a company, they will give you a laptop. So like that, you have n number of developers. Don't think every developer will go into install Hadoop environment in his laptop. That is local machine. So what administrator will do, right? Administrator will just going to give you an account for each developer. So you have to log in with that account and you have to place some files into the cluster. So you from your local machine, you will going to have only Outlook configured. That's it. From a local machine, you will use PuTTY or any tool where you can go into log into your gateway machine. So from local laptop, use PuTTY to log into the gateway machine. As this gateway machine is already configured with the cluster, it will just going to communicate with that cluster when you perform any actions with the Hadoop commands. Understand, right? So these are the three things I just want to let you know. Don't think that everything will be performed in a single machine. Okay, usually developer will use gateway machine to communicate with the cluster. So let's say your Hadoop client is running here. Okay, what will going to happen when you are trying to place a file? So let's talk about our write architecture here. How Hadoop will going to behave when you are trying to place a file. Okay, let's say here. So let me clear this one. Okay, so look at this here. In the cluster side, you will have a masters and slaves. This is master and these are your slaves. Okay, now your Hadoop client, you are trying to place a file. From your local machine, you logged into the gateway machine. I have a file and the size of the file is what, 200 MB. So when you are trying to give it to Hadoop client, the Hadoop client will going to divide the data into small parts. And I said, right, there is a limitation of the division part. Yes, the file will be divided into small parts and each part is called block and each block will be identified by a unique block ID. So you can use B1, B2, B3 and B4. These are the blocks. So you have a file named file1 which was divided into 4 blocks, 200 MB, right? Why? Because the minimum block size that in the Hadoop 1.0 is 64 and in Hadoop 2.0 it is a 128 MB. Assume that you got a 64, and 64 is a logical size of the division. It's not a physical size of the file part that you have divided. So let's say in the step one, who has divided the file into blocks? Your client machine. Okay, when you are dividing, automatically this client is configured with the default properties. What is the default property? Right, the block size should be minimum 64 MB, and there will comes with a default replication factor that is called 3. The framework will going to come with all these defaults. The replication factor is 3. So whenever you are trying to place a file, these are the defaults that comes with your Hadoop file system. Understand, right? Now, so now client has divided the data, but client has to distribute the data into the slaves. Client cannot communicate with the slaves directly. Why? Because slaves won't send any status to client. It will going to send all their heartbeat and their availability of the files and everything to your master. So heartbeat will going to let you know the availability of the particular slave, whether that one was there in the machine in the cluster or not. Right? So client, there is no use if it communicates with the slave. So whom he will going to communicate? I already said that this client is configured to communicate with the master. So in the second step, this client will go and ask the master, can you please give me the addresses of the slave for each block, and how many slaves you want for each block? 3 slaves you want. So the name node will going to receive the metadata. Remember, you didn't passed 200 MB. Your 200 MB is still with your client only. You are telling to the master that you have divided that file into B1 comma B2 comma B3. You are talking about logical divisions of the data, but you really didn't share the 200 MB to the master. So master really don't have the huge all data. It will have hardly very small data. That is like a data about data, which is called metadata. Master really don't have any physical data. Okay, just transforms to the master, and master is already receiving the heartbeat of the slaves. So what it will do, right? Oh, the slave is free. You can place that particular block in that slave. So it will going to think like, okay, the slave is free. Why can't we assign that particular block into this? Okay, clear, right? So block B1 will be placed in the slave 1. And remember, your master won't place again the same replica in the same data node. That process is called block placement strategy. What master will going to do, right? Whenever it trying to place a file, master will follow some block placement strategy. So it won't place again the block in the same slave. So it will going to give you the other slave. So you are asking the master to give each block 3 data nodes. So first one is called primary replica, and 2 other things are called secondary and third one replica. Understand it? This is for backup, because if one machine lost, you can going to retrieve the data that was there in that machine in other way. That is what replication. So B2 will be placed the primary in S2, and then S3, and then S4, and B3 will be placed in slave 3 and slave 4 and slave 1. Remember, it won't going to place all the replicas in a single machine. All 3 replicas won't be placed in a single machine. So it will got distributed into multiple machines. So like S4 and S1, S2. So this is what the third step your master will going to perform. Your master will just going to perform all these tasks. Okay, so this is hardly 1 MB, less than 1 MB. This is a metadata, understand, right? This is the third step. Okay, once master assigns the address of the slaves for each block, that information will be given back to the client. In the fourth step, that information will be given back to the client. So master won't going to distribute the data to the slaves, because master really don't have an actual data. In your real world also, manager and slaves, manager never assigns a task to the slaves. He will direct the client only. Client will ask manager, who are the resources free to perform a task? Then it will just going to find out, oh, these are the slaves you are free. Then that addresses of the slaves will be given to the client. Now client will going to distribute the data. Literally, client only divides the data and clients only distribute the data with the help of the master. So in the fifth step, it understand, okay, block B1 was placed in slave 1 and slave 2 and slave 3. All the 3 replications data information will be given to here. In the slave, this B2 got placed in slave 2 and slave 3 and slave 4. And block 3 got placed in slave 3 and slave 4 and slave 1. And block B4 will be placed in slave 4 and slave 1 and slave 2. Is it clear? So now all the metadata will be there with the client. Now client will going to place. So in the client, a client first will places B1 in this machine, and the replica of that one will be stored in this machine, because it won't store the same block again in the same slave. It is useless, right? If that slave will lost, all the replicas will be stored in will be lost. Okay. So B1 got placed here. First you might have a question like, all blocks, all primary replicas will be placed first. Remember here, all primary replicas means B1 was stored in that machine and B2 will all happen in parallelly. Okay, so first B1 will be placed here, B2 will be placed here, B3 will be placed here, B4 will be placed parallelly here. If B1 is good, successfully placed, then this B1 will be replicated in this machine. Remember, replications happen sequentially, but blocks, all blocks will be copied parallelly. Remember this point. Replications happen sequentially. Once this first replica was done, it will tell to that client that file got placed successfully, but actually the replication will going to happen at the asynchronously. So this is what going to happen in the fifth step. In fifth step, your client will going to place that particular blocks into the particular slave with the replication. So B2 got placed here and B2 was placed here as well and here as well. And B3 got placed here and B3 will be placed here and here. And B4 got placed here and B4 will be in this machine and as well as in this machine. So this is how actually the data will get and distributed in these machines. Once this particular slaves placed all the blocks, it will going to send notifications in the sixth step. Along with the heartbeat, the slaves will going to say that, they will going to send an acknowledgement saying that, hey, we received the particular blocks data in the sixth step. Once master receives that, oh, that blocks received successfully by that slave, means you will commit the metadata in the seventh step. Then in eighth step, it will going to close the connection with the client and it will say that, hey, we have done the task. Okay, these are all eight steps that happens whenever you going to write a file into the Hadoop cluster in a background. There is a command to place a file that is called fs-put, bin Hadoop fs-put command to place the file. Whenever you place the file, first division will be happen at the client side and communicates with the master to give the addresses of the slaves. And then that information will be communicated and then that data will be given to the client back. Client will going to places that particular blocks into this slaves. Once this successfully placed, it will send an acknowledgement to the master saying that we have received this. Then it will commit the data and then it will close the connection saying that file got placed successfully. So in this one, we would like to name, in this framework there should be a name for master and also there should be a name for a slave. So we will going to name it based upon the action. So the node which will going to give the address of the slave, which is naming the address of the slave, that is called name node. From now, don't call in HDFS master as a master, call him as a name node. Name node is a processor running on that particular machine on JVM. So the master is called the name node and the slaves, right, these are called nodes who will store actual data, that is called data nodes. Okay, so you will going to see three important things in this architecture: client, name node, data node. Client will divide the data and takes the help of the name node to distribute the data in the data nodes. The name node will going to give the address of the slaves. Then the name node will just going to give that locations of the slaves where you can place the data. Then client only will distribute the data into that particular slaves. This is how actually a write process will going to happen. This write will going to complete once it commits the metadata, and this will going to perform only once in write process. Understand, right? It Hadoop is like a file system which will write once and read many times. So this will be performed only once and the metadata will be committed. And we will going to see in the next video how to read the data. When I going to perform a command called fs-get to read the data, what actually happens by step, we will going to see. Thank you guys.